Scott here with CategoryOneGames.com, bringing you another Middle Earth CCG Player's Guide walkthrough. Now, this is the Dark Minions one, and one thing that stands out right off the bat is the company actually hole punched these, so that way you could put this in your binder and have it next to your cards, which I think is a really cool idea. So you could have your nine card pocket sleeves, and you'd have your card set in it, and then you'd have the Dark Minions Player's Guide next to it. Now, this is the third set from ICE that created the game. This is ICE's old logo, and this is put out for a help for anyone getting into the Dark Minions set. Now, just like the Wizards Player's Guide that I've reviewed before, if I find more of these, I will review them and put them on here. But this is the Dark Minions Player's Guide. Now, this one's actually in really pretty good condition. I think I have this listed as slightly played on our website. It's available for sale. So if you see this and you'd really like to pick it up, that's a great thing to have. This is an introduction to the Dark Minions. It has the contents here, what's inside. It has part one strategy guide. So new basic utility cards, new tactical considerations, new strategies. So this set, the third set, added in agents. And so it added a new way of playing and new strategies. It had odds of surviving. So if you have different combat and how that works with your dice rolls. Whoa, flipping through too fast there. It's got things like agent half strategies, how to deal with agents, mission cards. And so, I mean, this really goes in depth on how to use the different characters. It's a great thing to use for someone looking to get into the game and wanting to learn the rules in depth, or someone that's just getting back into it or wants to review how the game played. Now, this is actual decks. I think this is so cool. It has Underdeeps and Diplomatic Agents, the Queen and Her King deck, Advantage deck revisited, and new roadblock strategy. So if you remember the Wizards Player's Guide, it had a roadblock, it had different advantage decks. Well, these are updates to those with the new set. And this also, I don't have the Dragon's Companion anymore, the Player's Guide, but it also had this same sort of thing. So it has a part two card list. It lists out, here's a card index of all the different cards, characters, allies, resource events. Basically goes over what they do all in one source here. And then it gets to the actual cards from the set. So card entries, characters, and allies. So it shows you the different cards. It gives you a strategy of what they do as well as their lore. So this is the start of that. And there's less cards in this set. So this is a smaller book. So like here's resource events. And it walks you through all of them. A lot of resources in this one. Okay, here's agents. So this is that new card type. And so this walks you through how to play these and how they work. And if I'm not mistaken, they have kind of a purplish tone to them versus any of the other colors that were used at that time. So then here's creatures from this set. Hazard events. And this is a good set. I like this set a lot. It sells very well. It's very collectible. And then sights. And it wasn't in as high a print as some of the other sets. So there's the end of sights. Anyways, then it has kind of a glossary in the back. And that is the Dark Minions Player's Guide. I really like this set. And if I find more of these books, like I said before, I will put them on for you guys all to see. But I figured I'd show this to you as a great example of what a card game company did right by producing a book that gives you everything you need to know in one spot, gives you an idea how to play it, deck strategies, really an example of what card game companies should be doing with their product. This is Scott with CategoryOneGames.com.